Complaints from retirement village residents across the country were taken straight to the Beehive today. This, as it's revealed, 12 village operators have been warned by the Commerce Commission about potentially unfair contracts and false promises. Business correspondent Katie Bradford explains.
What is the measure of a full life?
They look great in the ads. An active, fun and healthy life at some of our biggest retirement villages.
We know everyone wants something different from retirement.
But it's the fine print in contracts, known as occupational rights agreements, that have some worried.
The advertising needs to be aligned to what's actually in the ORAs.
It's really concerning that the agreements that residents sign when they enter these facilities are fundamentally unfair in some cases.
Complaints have led to the Commerce Commission writing to 12 operators, including industry giants such as Ryman and MetLife Care, warning them they may be misleading customers or potentially breaching the Fair Trading Act. Some of those issues around a promise of continuing care when a resident falls ill.
Now it's up to them to come back to us with a response on our views, and that response could include things that they're willing to change.
The Commerce Commission has reviewed a handful of historic occupational right agreements, have identified a number of clauses they consider unfair. The operators have since adjusted those clauses.
This advocate for residents voiced his concerns at the Beehive today, meeting with Commerce Minister Andrew Bailey.
Very encouraging, it really was. We are readily responsible for 50,000 people to get the fairness and the consumer protection and the consistency, because in the current Act, those things are just not evident.
More than 11,000 submissions were received into a review of the Retirement Villages Act, which began last year. The new government says it's committed to that process, but a final report and any recommendations won't come out till later this year. There are also complaints about the use of exit fees and other charges.
You don't actually own any of the appliances in the residence that you have in these facilities, but the facility will force you to get them repaired.
The Retirement Village Association says 130 people move into villages every week. It's willing to work on an updated code of practice.
We've reached out to the Residents Association and we've asked to sit down with them so we can work through what those changes might be.
The Commerce Commission says it could still take further action, but it's watching and waiting to see what changes might be made to regulations first. Katie Bradford, One News.